Katie and Peter are enjoying the trip of a lifetime.
I love you.
I've got the tiger with me.
During a magical ceremony in the heart of the African bush, the happy couple reaffirmed their love for one another and have started a romantic new journey.
Hoping tonight some slight consummation going on.
Join Britain's most famous celebrity couple as they honeymoon in South Africa, a country where they can escape tabloid scrutiny.
Smile.
Strip their love back to basics.
I mean, that is a natural phenomenon.
And watch each other enjoy the wonders the world has to offer.
Who needs a facelift when you got wings? Woo!
So jump on board and witness Katie and Peter fall in love all over again.
This is my sense of adventure.
Morning has broken over the African bush, and it's been over 18 hours since Katie and Peter reaffirmed their love for one another.
I'm dying over here!
Today, Kate and Pete will be leaving the savannah and jetting off to Cape Town for their second honeymoon, but not before grabbing some breakfast.
Could I have a hot chocolate, please? Oh, thank you.
And a cup of tea, please. English breakfast.
Oh my God, I'm so cold.
Did you see him?
Yeah, I was just gonna
look at
get
him,
that.
He's up there. The cheeky
you
monkey.
Cheeky took
now
my
Now I
cake.
Know what they mean by cheeky monkey. Where did he come from?
He was over there. I was about to say how cute.
He's been watching, waiting.
I'll have to get a couple more now because they've got malaria
there.
On that.
Oh no, they're not.
I just turned my head and he nicked it. Can't believe that. I'm starving.
I didn't have any hot, cold stuff.
Yeah. Dream on.
Before going, the happy couple need to settle their bill. They agree to leave their mobile phones back in the UK and have been using the hotel telephone. They may have just confirmed their eternal love, but that's not stopping Katie from keeping Peter on his toes.
345. Well, who's 345?
You tell
Pete?
Me. You made
no,
a call. I didn't.
Swear on my life. So who's 345 then, Pete?
I don't know.
345.
That number.
Well, hang on. What about
no,
you?
No, I'm
you...
going to check this number.
When you were...
Because I have no. And I'm bringing it.
Okay. Come on, then.
I'm going to phone these. So who's 362?
No, I'm going to ring them. Don't try and get out of it.
No, I am, Pete. 874. Whose is that then, Pete?
Why are you asking me? What about you?
So the two numbers I need to find out is that one
and
that one.
And I'm going to find out too.
And it was at what time? 847. I was in my treatment then.
Yeah.
And this one, 8:53, I was in my treatment. And that one, you was on it for 8 minutes 28, Pete.
Maybe Gary made some calls.
I'm going to check them. Think I'm not.
Good.
Okay, get off.
There's only one way for Pete to prove his innocence, and that's to call the numbers.
That's 545. No, that's 345.
It doesn't exist. I can dial it for you.
Hang on. Oh, did you ring it wrong? Did it didn't connect?
Oh, hang on.
It's
Excuse
wrong.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
4 minutes.
I know exactly what it is.
What?
Are you thick? Look at the number and look at the number before. You put a 5 on it. You were trying to ring your mum, you plonker.
You no, don't. I wasn't.
Oh,
it's the same number
okay.
as that
It's the
one.
Same number but with a 5 at the end, you plonker.
You just press 5.
So
okay,
obviously...
let's do number 11.
Oh,
that, that's
number
the one
11.
I just did.
Look, it's the same number. 827. Do you know
Say
what?
Say thank you.
You eat humble pie and you apologise.
Because you was all like, yeah, I'm going to see who this is.
I didn't think of... Say sorry.
I'm sorry that I thought it was you and say sorry that you thought you could
Give
catch me.
Give me a kiss and tell me you love me forever.
No, don't tell me to say it.
Now that Pete knows he can't take anything for granted, the couple head off to their private jet. And Kate's feeling a bit on the wild side.
I've got the tiger in me!
All right.
Excuse me, I'm sorry.
No,
I
didn't!
Cape Town, here we come! Woo!
Katie might be attracting more attention than the local wildlife, but the time has come to leave the game reserve that's been their love nest for the last 3 days.
Okay.
Thank you, be great guys. Thank
okay.
you.
Okay.
And we'll be glad to come back.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh my god, you don't want to look out there, Claire.
There'll be no work or kids on this trip, allowing Katie and Peter to escape their celebrity status and daily lives. It's been some time since they've had such a luxury.
Oh, how green is it? What a completely different looking place.
It's Table Mountain.
Oh yeah, that's stunning. That is a beaut. I like this place already.
Why?
Dunno, there's a vibe. Where we are, guys, Cape Town. It's one of the places I've always, always dreamed of coming to. I'm in South Africa. It looks like a real buzzing town.
The lovebirds only have 3 days to explore Cape Town together, but the last thing you need on honeymoon is a spanner in the works.
Pete's gonna have a heart attack because he's lost my wedding ring.
No, I haven't lost your wedding ring, but I don't like taking responsibility for your stuff. I know where all mine is. You're not kidding me, right?
I swear my life, I've got a bag.
Shit.
Unless it's fallen out on the aeroplane, which it could have done.
Kate, these rings.
Did you do the zip up?
Huh?
Did you do the zip up?
Yeah, I did.
You got them?
Well, I'm not having much luck at the second, no. If you've got them, don't mind me about. She's got them.
I swear on my life I haven't got them.
Do you know, you and your swearing on your life, which you lie about so many times, I don't believe you anymore.
I've not got the rings. I promise you I haven't.
Well, I wouldn't be laughing if I was you, because that is not a laughing matter.
Pete, I'm not laughing. I really haven't got them. I promise you.
They're in the safe. I just put them in there. I just put them in the safe.
Say sorry.
Sorry.
Now, who's got memory loss?
Me.
Oh my god, I look. Oh my god, I've got so much to weigh.
Yeah,
I've eaten so much
food.
Yeah,
but not all that. You're gonna weigh more. I'm telling you, and you're not gonna like yourself. Kate, you're wearing clothes. You're gonna be heavier than you think you are.
I don't compete. It's natural.
And you're gonna say I weigh.
Oh my god, I weigh 8 stone exactly.
So what's your problem then?
Because I've put on 4 pounds.
Ooh.
Oh my god, I can't believe it.
Kate,
hey, what are we gonna do? Oh my god, I look so ugly. How could you let me walk around like this?
Well, come on then, let's go.
My hair!
Can we go have a coffee?
But just because you look good. Did you just have a pee in here?
Yeah, I did.
Stink! God, your urine stinks. You need to drink more water.
Do you know what?
Or should I go down like that?
What? Why? Why do you have to go on your tiptoes, pull that in, and do this with your mouth? What is that shit?
Excuse me,
But what
can
is
I have
that?
A hot chocolate, please? Because I'm very cold. Unless you've got a jacket and you're warm and warm, right? Whatever. Get out,
oh,
I need to go with
you. Idiot. Trying to...
Pete!
What?
Now, when you go to the toilet, what have you always learnt to do?
Shut up, Kate.
Right. No, flush
wee.
It. No wonder I could smell it.
You know what?
All of you, get out. I'm going to wee.
Don't talk about
Love
smelling.
You.
Don't talk about smelling.
No, we won't, will we?
No, we won't.
No, we won't go
we?
There, will we?
How about you say
no.
sorry?
How about you say sorry?
Say
smellish?
Sorry.
Talking of smellish, you want me to
do
go
you want
there?
Me, do you want me to go
God,
there?
Go make up
say
whatever
sorry.
You want.
Say
no,
sorry.
Say whatever you want.
Say sorry.
Smelly.
Right, okay.
Go on, and
right,
then I'll go.
I'm going to tell you what Let's she did
see
the
ya.
Other night.
Then the other night?
Yeah.
So I'm wondering what you've done.
Well, you're gonna make up some shit now.
No, I don't need to make
say
up
sorry.
Shit.
Say sorry.
You say sorry.
Say sorry.
Let's say sorry.
Sorry.
Thank you.
Say sorry.
So you say it as well. 1, 2, both of us.
I
one,
just
two,
said
three,
it.
Go. I'm not saying it.
Okay, don't
just
piss
do it after
me
three
off.
And it's equal.
But I just said it.
I didn't know I'm deaf. 1, 2, 3. Huh. Sorry. Right?
Idiot.
Plonker.
Hurry up.
Shut up!
I didn't say it the second time. I wasn't going to let her win. She would have won because I would have said it twice and she would have said it once.
Honeymoon or not, when it comes to their competitive streak, normal service has resumed.
Was that a fart?
No, it's not. I don't do things like
Let's
that.
Let's go down.
You don't need your glasses, Pete. It's getting dark in a minute.
Hey, I do what I want. Let's go.
So you're wearing glasses and you're wearing your coat?
Yeah.
Who the hell do you think you are?
Jose Feliciano. Come dance with me.
Come dance with me.
Come dance with me.
All right, you want Strictly Come Dance and sign you up now?
I can't.
I'm okay. You're so predictable.
I didn't say nothing.
They are. They're going to go, wow, look at that natural beauty.
Look at her. Look at her. What a slag.
I'm checking out the view.
I'll tell you what, if they went near you and smelt it, they wouldn't be happy.
Oh, sorry. Oh, hi. Look, when I don't give you love...
Yeah.
Hey, hey. See, only when it's role play you want to know, you sicko.
That's right.
Hey, where's your wife? Hey?
She's out of town.
Mama back.
We're in a fucking town. Huh? You want that?
Oh, yeah.
Go on.
Coming up, Katie and Peter's romance reaches dizzy new heights.
This is it.
And our celebrity couple look forward to their future.
I don't know, when you're older, you're going to be one grumpy old woman, you are.
Katie and Peter are enjoying their second honeymoon and newfound freedom in South Africa. Unrecognised and with no paparazzi relentlessly pursuing them, they can relax and hit the tourist trail.
What makes me laugh is normally when you come to places like this, I suppose it's like when people come to Brighton, they go in all the shit shops along the seafront, you know, just like tacky, like riffraff. And here I am in South Africa and I actually want to look in their riffraff shops. It's so weird when you're a tourist, the shops you go in, because if I lived it, I probably wouldn't even look twice at these shops.
Shopping will have to wait because they've decided on an excursion that will give them a rare chance to kick back, relax and reflect.
It's never been better. We're so close and it just feels so right. I know it sounds... probably sounds a bit cheesy to people, but, you know, we have been through a lot of ups and downs and this has just ended up being so perfect for us. Best thing is we didn't bring our phones. I reckon that's a really good thing for couples to do sometimes. Don't bring your phones. It just brings you closer, gives you more time to communicate. Beautiful.
The vessel has reached Seal Island, home to a very chilled out colony.
Look at that. I know, amazing, I know.
It is actually, look how many there are.
Thousands of them.
Oh, I want one.
I want one.
Reminds you of car thing.
Do you know why did you? That's exactly what I thought.
Did you?
Yeah, because it's that cute,
it is
cuddly.
It's like a seal when he's in the water.
He just bobbles and he's like.
That is so cute. Face.
Look at this, man. It's amazing. I would love to go up there. I would love to.
We are.
Are we allowed to touch?
Yeah, they're getting their special shoes.
No, they're not.
They are, Pete. They've got special grips. They're going to give you a seal suit. Wow. That is huge. Oh, my God, that one's absolutely huge.
Do you know what? We have seen some pretty spectacular things in our lives, man. Oh, yes, gorgeous, eh?
The thing is, if you take pictures of, like, that beach, when you'll get home, you're like, what on earth did I take that picture for? So many people, when you look at pictures, they take it with views.
Yeah, but
at least
some people love...
have you in the view. If you've got the view and yourself.
Some people love the view. That's...
Yeah, but you go home and it's like, you might as well buy postcards.
You might as well, but you don't have to because you've got a camera.
Yeah, but when I'm older, I'll be into all that.
I don't know. When you're older, you're going to be one grumpy old woman.
I must sound so ungrateful. I'm not. I'm just...
You are.
I'm not at all. This is brilliant. This is fantastic. Wow. It's amazing.
Escaping the celebrity circus seems to be allowing Katie and Peter to simply be Mr. and Mrs. Andre for the day, especially when an unexpected welcome party is waiting in the harbour.
There's a big thing of Africa I want to get, Claire. I'll show you. It's carved out. I love this, man. Jeez, I'm having such a good time. I know. I'm very excitable. It's not my fault. That's what I want to get. Good day, guys. I want a carving of Africa. This one or this one? I'll ask my wife. Wait.
I don't like that for the wall either, do you?
Just to hang up. Isn't that beautiful?
Oh, no.
No?
We're going trendy modern, Pete.
But it's Africa, baby.
I don't like it.
In the past, Pete's admitted that Kate's the one who wears the trousers, but now they're getting on so well, he's prepared to put his foot down.
Now, do you know what? I do like them. I am going to get them. I get the coasters. I get these two. I thought about it. Kate didn't want it, and I'm thinking, well, I'm buying it for her. I'm buying it for me. You're a good woman. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Bye, see you later.
With his pride and souvenirs intact, a newly confident Pete leads Kate to Cape Town's most famous tourist attraction. Table Mountain sits 3,500 feet above the Western Cape, and the cable car to the top isn't for the faint-hearted, especially if you have a fear of heights like Peter.
I don't really like heights, really. In fact, I really don't like heights. Hey, do you like heights?
No.
Well, why aren't you worried?
It doesn't scare me one bit.
Why?
Because I'm enclosed.
But you're not in control.
No, but it's slow.
Do you don't mean to eat that?
He's a little bugger.
Don't mean to eat it?
No. Well, yeah, go on then. Put it, my finger in your mouth. Eat it. Eat it. You're gross.
That stung me. I'm passing out. Oh, I can still taste it.
Give me a look. Ah, yeah, a little bit. Oh, yum.
Yeah. That ladybird stung my mouth and it's got disgusting taste.
Well, it'll be flavour and shit.
Hoping you can't catch tropical diseases from ladybirds, the couple make their way to the cable car. And while they're waiting, Kate spots a memento from another romantic trip they took in the past.
That has been a good buy, that watch.
I love this watch.
Mm. I bought that when it was my birthday. And I remember I was so heavily pregnant. Pete really wanted sex, put on a porno, and I was lying there in bed, so I went in the other room and went on the sofa. And in 10 minutes later, he said, "Don't be so stupid, just come in," because he made me feel really ugly and unattractive.
This is it. Which I like.
Really I don't go,
It's very animal instinct.
No, George, you know what you do?
Wow.
With your toes and like that, and you're like, that's you.
Okay, yeah, I do a bit of...
Or
bit
this.
Of... This is you.
He's making... You know he's making it.
No, I'm not. This
yes,
is you.
Yes, you are. Pete.
Go cross-eyed.
Cross-eyed, you don't do that much good to me.
You do, you go cross-eyed.
Oh, it's better than going... Don't get scared now.
Oh, come on, look at that.
It's not even that bad, is it?
Oh, my God, I'm going to get scared of it. I do get a little bit scared of heights.
Not bad.
No, looking up's good, but looking down. goodness, that's a bit crazy. Is that not freaky? Oh man, I can't even.
But you're not scared?
No, I'm just feeling a bit weird. No, I don't want to look.
He's gonna have a panic
attack. No, I'm not gonna look. I swear I'm not gonna look.
Hey, look at the cliff now.
No, I don't want to look at
the cliff. Oh, here, you're safe here, look.
That freaked me the hell out.
I want me to take a picture.
Jesus Christ. Oh, Jesus, look at these. Are these people mad?
They're rock climbers.
Now, that I couldn't do, could you?
No, but yeah, right. I can't even go up on a cable car. I'm going to go do that.
Coming up, our celebrity couple continue their joyful journey. And Katie tells Peter exactly how she feels.
I love you.
It's the 15th of September and a raging storm is brewing in the Southern Hemisphere.
Room service!
However, the inside of Katie and Peter's honeymoon suite is harmonious, and the hotel has delivered a healthy exotic platter for two.
When's the last time we sat and had breakfast together?
Never. Do you know what? I can't eat this health. I need scrambled egg or something
now. Do you want some? Shall we bring them?
No, because I've got to lose weight. You know, I'm so not a healthy person. This does nothing for
me. Shall we order some scrams?
Come on, then.
What do you want? Scrambled and what? The whole English, right?
You won't eat a whole English.
I didn't say I want one. Do you want a whole English?
No.
What do you want?
I want loads of scrambled egg with about 10 eggs in it. I want a big portion, big enough for a king.
My wife wants scrambled eggs with 10 eggs, please. Do you want anything else, babe?
Mushrooms.
Mushrooms.
Tomatoes.
Do you know what? I think you should just give her a full English breakfast, yeah. Thank you. With extra scrambled eggs, thank you very much. And for me...
Gentleman Peter is so in tune with his wife, he knows exactly how to keep her happy.
I thought I'd wake up today and I thought, no, I'm going to be healthy today. And I'm up 10 minutes, and already I'm on a full English breakfast. I've never eaten so much in my life.
There you go, my love.
Pete, do you know what? When you're comfortable with someone, it's so true.
What?
You pile on the pounds.
This trip has made me fall in love like it was yesterday, like it was the beginning. Serious.
Thank you.
I wasn't expecting a thank you. But I knew you thought I was expecting an answer.
Do you know, people at home must think, why is he with her? Because she's so, like, blunt.
They do think
but
that.
I'm not like that. But I seem to come across that, but
because
I'm not.
You are like that.
Pete, you wouldn't put up with someone who was like that.
But I have you put must... up with it. But it's you... because I love you that much.
But you must get it back. You wouldn't be with someone who doesn't give it back. So if I was that grouchy, that moody, that unloving, as they think, why would you still be with me in 5 years?
You give a lot of love.
Thank you. Can you let people at home know I'm not always grouchy?
You give a lot of love. But, there is a but. When you're good and ready, that's the difference. You're short, you're moody. Can you let me finish?
Yes.
You're moody and you're short up until you finished your work, 8, maybe 9 o'clock at night, you're the best. All of a sudden, I see this love come out. Right? We sit on the couch, we watch movies.
So really, I'm your best mate.
You're my best mate at night. Your absolute nightmare in the day. On this trip, it feels like when I first met you.
Do you know, we haven't even bickered once.
Oh no, it's been brilliant.
Oh my gosh, there's your 10 eggs, okay?
The bottom line is, everyone wants me to say it. They never hear me say it, is that I love you. Thank you. Now, that is what you call full English breakfast.
Oh, my God, full English breakfast? That's a full English
yummy
army.
In my tummy.
A cooked breakfast seems like the right choice given the weather front that's rolling in. But thankfully, they've got a warm and dry 2-hour drive east to the final destination of their honeymoon.
Very different day today than yesterday.
There's a whale out there. Left, right.
Oh, yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Sick.
There's another whale there.
Where? What? Do you know how whales travel? On a whaleway track. Woo!
Failing to amuse Katie with his sparkling wit, Pete resorts to plan B.
Ten seconds.
I've gone from tickling to kissing my
tits.
Yes.
Oh no, I am ticklish though.
You've
right.
only got to say just
think it's not okay, it's not tickling.
The final few days of their honeymoon will be spent in Grootbos, a nature reserve near the most southerly point of Africa, where the Atlantic meets the Indian Ocean. It's a rugged, wild, romantic wilderness, the perfect place for a cosy cuddle.
I could hold you in my arms. I could hold you forever.
Katie and Peter's love is certainly in the African air. They couldn't care less that they're in public, and now Kate's the one who can't keep her hands off her husband.
We've got such nice feet from there.
I could hold you forever.
The honeymooners will be staying in an isolated five-star lodge, perfect for privacy. But they've got to face the elements to get there.
I want my mummy.
It's only raining, look at me. It's freezing. Honestly, people at home, I'm not moaning for nothing. It is freezing.
Bloody hell, it feels like we're in the jungle again.
Brilliant. Lovely. How cosy. Oh, that's going to be nice. We'll have a big roaring fire. Perfect. Yes.
Oh wow, it's lovely.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah.
Absolutely. They're going to put the fire on.
Is that pool warm?
No.
No.
How gorgeous if it's hot here to come here.
Apparently
how
yesterday
private.
It was 35 degrees.
No.
Yesterday, yeah.
Oh, this is so nice. This is really, oh my God, look at the bathroom.
Suitably impressed with their romantic getaway, Katie and Peter unpack, run a bath for two, and enjoy some time alone.
Slightly excited.
A few hours later, and our amorous adventurers are invited to a remote lodge that's perfect for viewing the ocean.
Hopefully we'll see some whales in close-up. We're pretty big Toros today. We've got our Toro cameras. And then I wanted her to know that she's amazing, beautiful. You're amazing.
You're fit.
You're sex. Oh, this is gonna be great.
Oh, I hope so.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
The locals say you can experience four seasons during one day in this part of the world, but Kate and Pete have mainly been rained on. Still, it hasn't dampened their spirits because beauty is all around.
How would you explain that? It's incredible. I know, I get fascinated by things like this.
Thank you. This bay is renowned for seeing calving whales this time of year, but it seems the only thing the ocean is offering up is a spectacular storm. But it's not stopping Katie from performing a whale song of her own.
Wow, it's not that windy, honest. Woo. Who needs a facelift when you've got wind?
Woo! Whoa! We saw exactly no whales.
Coming up, Pete gets up close and personal with one of the world's deadliest animals.
No! Woo!
It's the last day of Katie and Peter's second honeymoon, and they're up at 7 a.m. because today's experience is one Pete's been waiting for.
Morning. Morning. Right and early.
Our lovey-dovey pair have been inseparable on this trip, but no matter how much Kate loves Pete, she draws the line when it comes to diving with great white sharks in the ice-cold Atlantic.
It looks nice out there, but it's still freezing cold, and I really would love to do it. I loved this adventure. But it's just too cold for me.
Thankfully, Pete's looking forward to diving with the man-eaters, even though he's a little sluggish.
You only having hot water?
Yeah.
Well, talking of hot water...
Actually, it's not
never
true.
Never underestimate the pricing.
I actually wanted a coffee, but all there was hot water, so I thought that'll do until I get my coffee. Oh, yeah. That's just great, that is.
Pete usually needs caffeine to kickstart his mornings, but perhaps he's running on adrenaline today, as in a couple of hours he'll be face to face with one of the world's most feared predators.
Hope I don't get bitten by a shark.
Of course you won't. I bet it's weird. I bet when you see the shark, you'll have respect for it like it will for
you. I do. I respect it already.
They've hired a private boat and will be jetting off into deepest shark territory. Action man Peter is feeling brave and Katie is well prepared.
We are.
Got my hot water bottle under my jacket.
No, it actually feels warm.
Actually, that cage is bigger than what I thought.
Oh, that's right up close and personal to the fella.
Can you see the black floats on the cage? Those little marks you see, they're actually teeth marks. Not from the sharks, from the divers. I'm joking.
Can I tell you something? It does not make me nervous at all.
It doesn't look good.
No, the only thing that's making me nervous is the thought of the cold going in the wetsuit.
The adrenaline will keep you warm. That is wicked. I love that.
The boat has reached its destination and drops anchor in what everyone hopes will be shark-infested water.
I'm going to prepare the boat to get us some sharks in. The bait's going to go in.
I'll stay with Pete till he goes on, so I'm nearby.
Okay.
And then when he's in...
That's love.
Of course it is.
Or she can't be bothered moving.
Not at all. You'd
right,
like
so
it
you
if I...
So you can see your turn mind heading out now?
Oh, my God. How are you going to get in now? I don't know.
But I'll only get in when we see a shark.
Oh, it'd be freezing, my God.
Yeah, I'm feeling a little bit queasy.
Is that all the sweets you've got left?
Yeah, we're on rations now.
Are you serious?
Green apples also work. And we have
Do they?
Some of those. Yeah, try green apple.
It's coming. The shark will be here soon, I'm telling you.
Everything's being done to attract the great whites, but for one member of Kate and Pete's camera crew, the rocking boat and chopping up of fish guts proves too much.
Mike, do you feel sick?
Good bad boy.
I can't bear that.
Mike, think of lamb chops.
No.
With loads of fat.
Fuck off.
The Andre's getting ready. Will the seasickness reduce once I'm in the water?
It works on some. Yeah. Just don't get changed in the cabin. The cabin's the worst place to be. So they're going to give you a wetsuit. She's going to just
get... Hang on, let me focus on someone first.
Oh, I feel a bit icky.
Dive in the cage. There's a cold
can. I'm going to be so cold. Wish me luck.
Where do you put it?
No, let me take a picture.
Cool. I'm going to give this a shot. Looking forward to it. Really looking forward to it. Feeling a bit queasy. Don't want to throw up in the shark's face. This is my sense of adventure. Ladies and gentlemen, see you very soon. Hopefully without a shark bite.
Trying it.
Oh! Okay, a little bit chilly on the old...
I feel for him.
It's okay. I'm having a wee. It's nice and warm in my body.
Oh, you can stink of urine.
Fantastic.
Pete, you must watch your feet on the cage, eh? Because there's a lever at the bottom. And if you stand on it, it's the eject button, so the bottom of the cage falls off, you're going to slip through.
Okay. I'm on the black rubber thing.
I'm joking.
Oh, okay.
Now that the shark's the star attraction, it's keeping everyone waiting in true celebrity style.
Okay, feeling a little queasy now.
But with the sea bobbing him about and pungent shark bait swirling around his cage, Pete takes the crew's advice to sit on deck and eat an apple.
This isn't helping at all.
Does anybody want a sandwich?
Oh, God, no, thanks.
I think we've got ham, cheese, cheese, tomato, and chicken mayo.
Honestly, I'm waiting to see Finn. And then the music. Dun-dun, dun-dun.
Shark in front, bigger shark, just over here in the water.
How do I see this? Get out,
get out! Down!
Woo! Yeah!
I'm coming, please! Did you see its jaw open?
Yeah.
She is a beauty.
Did it scare you a bit?
No. That's absolutely awesome. She came right up to the cage.
That was brilliant with its jaw open.
Being just metres away from one of the world's most lethal hunters took Pete's mind off his seasickness, but now he's back on board.
Not the tail.
Yeah!
Oh, Jesus!
That was fantastic. Nice bit of spew.
Pete might be freezing cold and green around the gills, but at least the love of his life is on hand to make sure he'll be all right.
Thank you. You are a good wife.
I know.
It's just in times like this.
Leaving the contents of Pete's stomach in their wake, everyone returns to dry land because it's time for the honeymooners to pack up and fly home to their family. As they arrive at the airport, Katie and Peter's decision to leave the kids, reaffirm their love and make their marriage stronger appears to have been the right one.
Oh, see, I love it when you let yourself go. When your barriers come down, you're the best. Whoop, that's what I do. Good man.
That's an epic football.
Yeah, you should see what I do to her when she calls.
When he does a bit of that, woohoo! Yeah. I have you screaming like a wolf.
I like that, do it again.
What does it mean?
It means I'm about to smack your booty.
If somebody is maybe nice, driving nicely, everything like that.
As well as a local mating ritual, the loved-up couple will be returning with fantastic memories. South Africa has seen Katie and Peter fall in love all over again, but it also brings the end of the series. Over the last 4 months, it's been out with the old.
I hate this
house.
No,
it's a lovely house.
No, it's not.
It is
a
lovely house.
Can't wait to get out of here. We've had nothing but trouble. I hate this house.
And in with the new.
This. Bought. This.
Katie and Peter have had their ups.
We believe the record has been set straight and our names have been cleared.
And their downs.
What's the matter? Talk to me.
I just want to die.
For the first time in their 3-year marriage, they've spent time apart, pursuing their own interests.
This is what I call home. This feels right.
Creating tabloid speculation that their marriage was over. But the reality is, Kate and Pete return home in love to the most important people in their world.
Pringle!
Get ready
Junior.
For the kids. Get ready for the kids. Where's Harvey? Do you think he's going to be there? What time is it? You're joking. What time is it? No.
We're here.
We're here.
JJ! Can you open the door, please? How do you do this? Oh. JJ! Yay! Princess!
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Are you coming?
Did you miss me?
Oh, Nick. Hello.
Did you miss? I'm good, Nikki. How are you? Yay. Did you miss us? How much?
Looking at the camera. Kiss.
I missed you. Princess, kisses. Princess, kiss.
Have a kiss, Junior.
Give your mummy a kiss. Take your dummy out.
I'm going to get you some toys to do.
Hey, he is here.
Oh, wicked.
Kiss him and cuddle. Good.
Is he?
Come and sit. Oh, good. Even better. Come and sit on the chair, Harvey. Yeah, this one.
Me?
Already she wants mum. Already she can't handle it. Yeah. Princess. Oh, mate.
The last 10 days haven't just been about Kate and Pete.
Daddy and mummy are going to renew their love. Now, you don't understand what that means, but it just means it's better for all of us. It means it's going to be stronger. We're all going to be a strong family, OK?
They wanted the family as a whole to take a big step forward.
Come on, then, walk. Come on, let's see you walk. Is she walking, Junior? Stand up. You can do it. Stand up. You can do it. Yay! Come on in. Stand up. You can do it. You can do it. You can do it. Come on. Good girl, stand up. You can do it. Yay! Give me a kiss. Good girl.
We're gonna say goodbye, guys. It's been an awesome series. We'll see you next season. Who knows, maybe even another child. We don't even know yet. All the best, guys. See you later.
Bye.
Think to myself, what a wonderful world. stay with ITV2 for a hilarious take on the horror genre with Scary Movie next.